everyone from Our Lady of the Pines. It's Carl and Ali here, and we just want to say a big hello and a giant, giant congratulations on celebrating your very special 100th episode of The Ferris Wheel of Fun with Mr Ferris.
How good, it's unbelievable. I can remember when The Ferris Wheel of Fun reached its 50th episode last year, so to get to 100 is just amazing. And I was a little bit worried about that Mr Ferris taking over my job last time. That was very, very scary for me. So I'm glad that we've got through
that. We're still in contract negotiations, but it could still happen. It is an incredible achievement for your school. 100 episodes of all the magic, the jokes, the competitions, the music videos.
Wow.
All the fun and entertainment Mr. Ferris has brought you, particularly as your school in Melbourne has endured your sixth lockdown.
Maybe we could broadcast our show from the OLOP TV studio. Maybe Mr. Ferris can join us in our studio here at Channel 9 one day. During your homeschooling, all your teachers and staff at Our Lady of Pines have really gone above and beyond to make sure that you continue to laugh, continue to smile, continue to stick together in what can be a very stressful time.
So, boys and girls, you really have such a great school community, and you are very lucky that you have people like Mr. Ferris, who does all he can to make sure that your school days are the best days of your life.
And a very big shout-out, too, to your school principal, Mr. Keeling, who has really looked after your whole school community during your lockdown and allows OLOP TV to continue even when you are back at school.
Maybe I need to ask Mr. Keeling if we could do a swap with TV hosts where Mr. Ferris can co-host the Today Show with Carl and I. We could send Carl back to primary school. Either way, we're thinking of you all, and again, we wish you all the best for your amazing school TV show as you celebrate your 100th episode, and we look forward to watching many, many more.
And Mr. Ferris, I'm watching you.
Oh, wow. Boys and girls, did you see that? I was trying to contain my excitement, but how amazing was that? Carl and Ali from the Today Show. Wow, from Channel 9, and they talked about coming on our show on OLOP TV and coming on to the LA to the Pines to do the show from here. And even talked about me going up to Channel 9 and hosting the Today Show. Woo! Oh, boys and girls, I've gone straight into it and I haven't even opened the show yet. So, boys and girls, welcome to the Ferris Wheel of Fun with Mr. Ferris. Oh, our 100th episode. Oh, I'm pretty excited here. I've been trying to keep it quiet for a little while, but I can't contain my excitement. 100 episodes. I just want to say a big thank you to everyone out there. I know there's been a big build-up for it, and especially for this show. But 100 episodes of fun, of entertainment, of magic, of games, of jokes, and all the things that you guys have been sending in and putting on the show. You know, the show started when we went into our very first lockdown, when we had last year, and we were doing something, and we thought, oh, let's just put some magic onto the shows. We might do it once a week, and then we said, oh, let's do it once a day, and then we thought, wow, let's do some more things. And then lockdown went into a bit longer and a bit longer, and it turned out to be that it was so valuable for the kids and the mums and dads and all the family members who've been watching the show. And then it's now become something that happens at our school all the time during lockdown, where it's most important, and also during the year. And the fun things that we've been able to do with all your wonderful staff who've come on the show, that's been fantastic, where you've been able to see all the talents from our teachers, but also the talents of our students, when we've had the boys and girls come on the show and broadcast to you, all the mums and dads watching outside, or the kids who watch it from in the classrooms, to be able to see what happens here at our amazing Our Lady of the Pines. So I'm super excited to be able to have achieved 100 episodes. So happy to be able to get a message from Carl and Ali. That's pretty special and pretty exciting, and just shows you how great this show is going and how big it's going, where they're actually watching it in real live TV land. This is so, so good. Now, boys and girls, we have got a super show happening today. It is going to be a big show. But I'll tell you what, as we do every time, guess what? Somebody's having a birthday. And the person having the birthday is the Ferris Wheel of Fun with Mr Ferris. Yay! So, as I would normally do, I'd get my list and I'd say, and today's birthday is someone who is, oh, from Our Lady of the Pines, and they are celebrating 100 today. Our 100th episode. So, boys and girls, now, mums and dads might know, what normally happens when someone reaches 100 and they celebrate their 100th birthday? Do you know, boys and girls? Maybe someone in your family might have received something special from someone special when they've turned 100. Maybe it's an aunt, or maybe it's an uncle or a grandparent or someone, or maybe a great-grandparent for a lot of you, maybe a great-great-great-grandparent. But when people turn 100, they tend to get a letter from the Queen. That's pretty special for when they've reached 100 and they get a letter from the Queen. So, boys and girls, guess what? You'll never believe it, but I know who's turning 100. Our show is turning 100. And guess what got sent into us all the way from England? We got a birthday card from the Queen. Yeah. This is amazing. On the back here, it says congratulatory message from Her Majesty the Queen. And inside here, it's got here on the front cover, the emblem, the crown of the monastery there with the Queen. And then as we open up, this is very, very special. I open up, you can see a photo. I'll tell you what, boys and girls, I'm going to come over to the camera just so you'll be able to see it, because this is very special. So hang on. I wish I had more people in the OLOP TV camera crew, and the thing will just come over here. I'm going to have to change this setting here on the camera. 1 second. Oh, boys and girls, if only we had a budget here. Here we go. We'll turn this in here and let's see if this one works. Got to try and push this button. Now, let me see. We'll get the start here. We'll open it from here. Can you see here? Where's the focus, Mr. Ferris? There you go. See, that's the emblem from Her Majesty the Queen. And as I told you at the back here, let's see if we can focus in here. There you go. Congratulatory message from Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth. I'm trying to read this backwards to you. We open up the card and look what it says. Here is a picture of the Queen. And the Queen, and the message says from the start, Her Majesty the Queen personally approved this card, which was specially designed for the transmission of Her Majesty's congratulatory messages to Australians. And then the wording says, Dear OLOP TV. Ooh, I'll straighten it up there. Dear OLOP TV, I am pleased to hear you are celebrating your 100th birthday. My sincere congratulations and best wishes on this very special day. And there's it from the Queen. And this is what gets sent to people who turn 100. And OLOP TV, we're 100 years old. Yay! That was super, super special. So thank you very much to her Queen, who's been... I wonder if she's watching the show. I wonder, I know that we have been going overseas with this show, and I know that there have been people over in London who've been on watching the show, but I wonder if it's got to the Queen. But we just want to say a very big thank you to the people who actually got in touch with their department to organise our 100th episode, having a 100th birthday card. It's very, very grateful for you for doing that. Now, boys and girls, we did say that being our 100th episode and our birthday segment here, and normally when we say the birthdays, I have to sing a happy birthday to you, but it would be a bit silly if I had to sing happy birthday to myself. So, boys and girls, someone got in touch with me and said that they wanted to sing a happy birthday to me. So, boys and girls, sit back, relax, as we've got two of our past guests on the show. I wonder if you remember, we've got Wilbur. And we've got Terry, otherwise known as Terry Bull. So, boys and girls, here's a message from Wilbur and Terry Bull.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back to OLOP TV. Yay!
Yay! Hi, how are you?
Oh, wonderful. Now, just in case you've forgotten, remember me, I'm Wilbur.
Hello, Wilbur.
Hi. Who are you?
Me? I'm good looking.
Oh, but what's your name?
Well, depends on what you want to say. But everyone should know me from an earlier episode of Ferris Wheel of Fun as Mr. Bull Terry. My first name is Terry, so I'm Terry Bull.
Oh, hi, Terry. You've got nice glasses.
Oh, thank you. I'm getting a little older now and I can't see, so I thought I'd make a spectacle of myself.
Oh, what a funny one. Now, Terry, we're here for a really special thing, aren't we?
Is that for my birthday?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, why is it?
It's the birthday of the Ferris Wheel of Fun. It's 100 episodes! Yay!
100? I can't even count to that. The only thing I know about 100 is, well, Mrs. Buckley, she has an IQ of 100.
Oh, that must make her pretty smart.
Well, I hope so.
Now, because it's such a special occasion, I've written a special birthday song.
A birthday song?
Yeah. Terry, would you like to sing with me?
Well, I think I would love to do that. Thank you, Wilbur.
All right. Boys and girls, we're going to sing a birthday song to the Ferris Wheel of Fun. Let's go!
Looking forward.
Yes, please, for sure.
There you go. Thank you so much, Terry Bull, and thank you, Wilbur. What a fantastic duo in their very first debut performance of a duet singing together. They're a lot of fun, and it's so good having you guys on this show. Thank you. This show has been full of different things, hasn't it, boys and girls? We've had lovely characters like that. We've had lovely students who've come on and shown us their talents, and especially our teachers with their teacher talents. We've had some magic. We've had things that you've done in the classroom. We've had some music videos. videos. Do you remember the music videos, boys and girls? We've been doing some more, and I have got another video that we're doing. I'll tell you what, this show was so big that we won't put it on this show. I'm going to save it for a couple of weeks, and I might put it out maybe at the end of the term as a nice little send-off for the end of the term there, or at the end of homeschooling, but that's one to wait for. And I know that there are other teachers at the school who are also putting together some music videos too, all for you guys. So boys and girls, it's so much more things to look forward to as well. Now, keeping up with the fun of this show, one of the most requested things that we've ever done on this show was the very fun paper, rock and scissors Ferris style. Do you remember the paper, rock and scissors? I think it was last year it would have been, I think, and we had Mrs. Holman and Mr. Green, and they had to play paper, rock, scissors. So you know how you do that, boys and girls, you go paper, rock, scissors, or one, two, three, and you're either a paper, or you're either rock, or you're either scissors, and whoever wins, they get a point. Well, in my game, the way we play it, we make it really, really super messy. Really messy. And boys and girls, I have gone top of the tree for this one. Like I'm talking, if we're talking special guests, I've gone way up to the two most senior people at our school. Our principal, Mr. Keeling, and our deputy principal, Mrs. Buckley. And so I know, boys and girls, most of you guys wanted to have Mr. Keeling and Mrs. Buckley come in and be on our show, but they were a bit hesitant. But guess what? I finally got them. We've got them, and I got to be able to get them on the paper, rock, scissors game. I don't think they knew what they were expecting. It was going to be something that is just so much fun. And so I've recorded. Now, we did do it outside. I didn't allow it to happen in the OLOP TV studio because it gets very messy. So we did go outside to do it. Now, boys and girls, we did have some problems with our microphones because it was such a windy day. So there is a lot of background noise with the microphones, and a lot of times you don't hear my voice and you just hear the wind noise. Sorry about that. I couldn't do anything about that after we had recorded it. But you'll understand, it's just all the wind there. But without hearing what they're saying, you will see the look on their faces just to see how much fun. So boys and girls, for our very special 100th episode, here's Mr. Keeling and Mrs. Buckley on paper, rock and scissors, Ferris style. Hi boys and girls, it's Mr. Ferris here. We're back for another episode of the Ferris Wheel of Fun with Mr. Ferris. And this time, I've got our principal, Mr. Keeling, and our assistant principal, Mrs. Buckley. Hello guys.
Hello. Hello, Mr. Ferris. G'day, guys.
They are normally such happy people, but they're a little bit concerned now because they've seen what happens on the Paper, Rock, Scissors Challenge, the Ferris Fun Style, and I think they know what's about to happen. But it's such a great job that you guys did, boys and girls. It's all on account of you for sending in your emails and telling us who you wanted on the show. And I think we got the most amount of emails from all classes to get Mr. Keeling and Mrs. Buckley on our show. So well done to you guys. See, it all works. And we've got them on. So thank you, Mr. Keeling and Mrs. Buckley, for coming on our show. But we're going to get straight into it, boys and girls, because we've been waiting and waiting and waiting for this. This is so much fun. So what we're going to do, as you know, we start with our first ingredient being our flour. So we're just going to put lots of flour in Miss Buckley's. We'll put lots of flour in Mr. Keeling. I would like a bit more. Here we go. Scissors, we know that the scissors beat the paper, and therefore the paper beats the rock. So, ready? I wish you the best, all the best to you. Here we go, boys and girls, for round one. Ready, set, go. No, gotta go again. Yeah, two out of two. Oh, you can see why they're on the leadership team.
Yeah!
It's Mrs. Buckley, and you know what we do, Mrs. We count down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You're going a bit grey there, Mrs. Buckley.
Oh, I like this game.
Mr. Keeling's ready to claim victory already, but that was only round one. We have got round two, where we get into my bag of tricks, and we've got some mayonnaise. So let's just pour. Oh, I will just sprinkle that all around.
Look at, look at that. Mrs. Buckley's put some extra on there for Mr. Keeling. But it all gets down to how good you are at paper, rock, and scissors. Are you ready?
Right.
1, 2, 3, go.
Oh, no!
It's Mr. Keeling. Are you ready, boys and girls? Count me down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I've got contacts on.
Mr. Keeling's contact lenses. They're somewhere in here, but we will keep going. Look how excited Mrs. Buckley is. Oh my goodness. But I tell you what, we're one apiece. So keep count, boys and girls. We're one apiece, and that was the mayonnaise. And the next stage we go to, can you remember what we're going to do? Some red tomato sauce. Oh my goodness. Here we go. Let's just put the red tomato sauce everywhere. Do a little happy face there for Mr. Keeling. Here we go. It's all in the challenge. Let's see who is our reigning champion. 1, 2, 3, go.
Oh, no!
It's Mr. Keeling again.
Whose idea was this game?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Doesn't that look amazing? It looks even funnier when you've got a beard on. Oh my goodness. Well, we are so far, we've got the flour, we've got the mayonnaise, we've got the tomato sauce. You know what comes next? Let's try some hot mustard. the hot mustard, let's just put it on this side. Oh, it's all stuck. Let's try some, there we go. There we go, some hot mustard, boys and girls. Woo-wee. This adds to the colour. I don't know if this is good for my job security. This might be the last of OLOP TV. I don't know. We'll see how far we go. So let's go one more time, boys and girls. Are you ready? Mrs. Buckley, Mr. Keeling, go. Mr. Keeling, yet Mrs. Buckley and I might both be in the unemployment line. We don't know yet. Let's see how far we go. This has now got the flour, it's got the mayonnaise, it's got the red tomato sauce, and the hot mustard. Oh, here we go, boys and girls. Are you ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Look at the face of our principal and assistant principal. How amazing is this? Oh my goodness, I'll tell you what, we have done so well. But whilst Mrs. Buckley is super excited, punching the air, we've got a couple of more things to go. Are you ready? Are you ready for the next round? The next round is, what shall we do? Should we tell them? They don't know about this one. And then... We will start over here with Mrs. Buckley.
It's not funny.
Are you ready? Oh, right in the middle. I'll just take out the eggshell so it doesn't go in her eyes. And we'll get one for Mr. Keeling as well. Oh my goodness. Here we go. The egg. Crack that in the middle there. Oh. Let's take out
the this one.
This just cements all the flour into the skin, into the beard. I remember back when Mr. Zerby did it and he got the egg in his face. He still got the egg in his face. You have a look at his beard. When you go close up and you ask Mr. Zerby, you'll find out you'll still see some food in his beard from when he was on the show. Are you ready? Mrs. Buckley, Mr. Keeley. On count of three. 1, 2, 3, go.
Yeah! You're joking!
And now it's Mrs. Buckley's turn. Oh my goodness. Are you ready, boys and girls? Mrs. Buckley takes a deep breath with the egg in her face. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I like this game. game now.
Mr. Keeling is back. He loves the game now. How good is that? Oh my goodness, that is amazing, Mrs. Buckley. That is incredible. Yes, boys and girls, you're not seeing things. This is our principal and assistant principal at work. How great are they? But I'll tell you what, because we've seen we've got one more ingredient which we've got. This one's my favourite. It's the chocolate sauce.
Yum!
Let's shake it up a bit and let's put this all over. Oh, that is just deep everywhere, all through. Oh my goodness. Here we go. Here we go. This has been such an ambitious achievement to be able to get our principal and assistant principal in on this game. All right, here we go, boys. This is for the championship. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Oh! Oh, are you kidding me? No!
It is Mr. Keeling. Oh my goodness. Are you ready, boys and girls?
I just heard the phone.
We'll get you to see. We've got, I'll tell you what, because this one is for the championship which you've won, Mrs. Buckley, I will give you the honours to be able to do it. This is your dream, Mrs. Buckley. Happy to make dreams come true, boys and girls, here on OLOP TV. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh, boys and girls, how amazing is that? Mums and dads, I bet you've never seen Mr. Keeling like this before. But I'll tell you what, we've got one more special thing because this is like top
special
of the tree.
Thing.
And because I might not have a job after this, I thought we'll do one more ingredient. We have got one more that they don't know about. Baked beans.
I don't like baked beans.
Baked beans. Mrs. Buckley, please, this is our last chance to be able to see if we can get Mr. Keeling in a plate of baked beans. Are you ready? We open up the can. Oh, this is just... This is... Oh, look at that. Oh, my goodness. And over here, too. Oh,
no.
That
I've got to win.
This is...
I've got stuff coming out my nose. Oh.
Boys and girls, never would you see this happen at any other school but Our Lady of the Pines. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3.
Oh!
Do you know that this has been the first time out of every time that we've ever done this that you guys have done it, and it's always been the same every time.
Right.
Ready? Do you know what happens there? Do you know what happens when you get two tiebreakers on every set? It means they both go down. Boys and girls, it's been so nice working at this school here. I'm not sure if I'll be back next year, but, oh, sorry, I should pull their heads up from the pillows again. But thanks so much to Mr. Keeling and Mrs. Buckley for what great sports they are on being on OLOP TV on our paper, rock, scissors. Thanks so much, boys and girls. Look forward to seeing you in the next episode, if we're allowed to have one. See ya. Bye.
Ah, how good was that? What great sports Mr. Keeling is and Mrs. Buckley. And at this stage, I still think I've still got my job. So what great sports. No other school would you ever see the school principal and the assistant principal playing a game like that. We are so lucky that we've got the two of them here at our school. And boys and girls, they do so much for you guys and the mums and dads and so much stuff behind the scenes that you don't see. And then they even come on OLOP TV to do something like that for you. So thank you so much, Mr. Keeling, and thank you so much, Mrs. Buckley. You guys are stars, absolutely. Now, boys and girls, we are at the end of our show. It has been a big show, our special 100th. So I do want to say a big thank you to some people. But before I do, there's one other special guest that wanted to come on our show. Boys and girls, this has been one massive show. I've just been doing the editing to it and I've realised it's going for quite a long time. So boys and girls, I'm going to have to cut it here and we're going to have to come back with the rest of the show in the next episode. So I hope you've enjoyed watching part one of our 100th episode. It's been pretty exciting. But I'll tell you what, boys and girls, part two, I think, is even better. I'm going to tell you, there is something that happens that has been the most amazing thing that has ever happened to me. And you think today's show was big? Wait till you see the next episode, part two of our 100th celebration, because we do have a very special guest. Could it be The Rock? Could it be John Cena? Maybe it's Mr. Zuby. Maybe it's one of the school kids from OLOP. Or maybe it's you on our show. So boys and girls, you'll have to stay tuned for our next episode, which is part two of our big 100th day episode. So boys and girls, as we always do, look after yourselves. Be nice to your mums and dads. And remember, together, we got this. I look forward to seeing you at the next episode. See ya. Bye.